Hi everyone, and welcome to our overview of production time entry for Business Central within Moniroo. My name's Adam McIntosh. Let's get into it. Before we get started, I want to give everyone a quick overview of WebSAN. We are a gold certified Microsoft partner located in Toronto, Ontario. However, we service customers all throughout the world. We've been in business for a couple decades now, primarily focusing on Microsoft Dynamics. And as you can see from our slide here, we have won numerous awards based on our expertise within the Microsoft space. So let's dive in and talk about what we're going to be reviewing today, and that being production time entry module for Business Central. This module allows for quick and easy data entry against a released production order. And I wanted to note that we actually do limit it against released production orders only. So in here, one can record time and materials produced against a specific production order routing step. So let's dive in and take a look. All right, so now we're in the production time entry window within Moniroo itself. This window can be accessed via the left menu pane shown here. You'll see the box icons bring up the production time entry window. Now, this window looks very similar to other Moniroo windows in that you can sort and filter the various headers just by clicking on that particular row. And you can also enable or hide various fields as well. You'll actually notice this window looks and feels very similar to the Business Central entry window as well, as it allows for fast, efficient entry just in a single line, as you see here. Within Moniroo itself, we've also added a few additional features. So we'll actually have warnings when you select a production order that might be overdue. So you can see in this case, this production order was due last year, and so it warns me of that. I can also limit entries to one's location. So as an example, if that production order is for a particular location and I'm not in that location, I can restrict that. And we'll actually show you at the end the approval functionality as well, because this entry is going to go for approval. So in this case, I select my production order. I select my item that I want to be working with. And here I'll just say, you know, type in the routing step. So you can tab through and type with your keyboard. You can select with your mouse. Any of the above works. In this case, I want to put some runtime in there. Actually, I'll make it a half hour as well. So in this case, I put 4.5 hours. So this represents 4 hours and 30 minutes. 4.5 doesn't represent 4 hours and 50 minutes. Sometimes people ask that question as well. I can denote the quantity that I created. So in this case, 4. And the very last checkbox here is finished. So you want to mark this when you complete all the tasks for that routing step. So it's assuming here, if I mark this, that I'm complete all tasks for routing step 20. Okay. You can save anytime you wish by clicking the save button. And there's actually some more info available at the very left-hand side here. So you can see here details about the quantity that you should be creating. There's serial lot tracking information as well. And I should note that the serial lot info does auto-populate from the item tracking lines if there are any. There's also a few additional fields like bin code as an example. In this case, we don't have bins, but if your warehouse was set up for bin tracking, you can set the bin there. And you can track just a few additional fields like the department dimension as well, okay? So it really depends on your configuration of Business Central, what would be available in this case, but you can set other fields if you wish. Now, you'll notice a lot of those fields were automatically populated as well. Again, we auto-populate fields where possible, okay? So once you are comfortable with the entry, you just click Submit at the bottom here. If you did want to create additional entries, you can click Add. If you clicked add by mistake, you can right click on a line and delete it. In this case, I'm just going to go ahead and submit. Oh, sorry, I have to click my line and submit. And here you'll see it's created entry 134. And actually in my submitted tab, you'll see entry 134 is pending approval. So now let's go log in as a supervisor and take a look at this document for approval. All right, so now I've logged in as my supervisor and gone to my approvals tab. You can find that via the thumbs up icon on the left menu pane. And I'm just gone to the production time entry subheading. So here you can see document number 134 that we just created. You can click on that, get the exact same view that the user had for the data entry earlier. You can review it, reject it, reassign it to another approver, or approve the document here as well. If you want to approve it from the main menu pane, just make sure you have the document selected before you click approve. All right, so now let's jump into Business Central and take a look at that document in there. So in Business Central, this actually created an output journal. So you can see here the work order number one for the item that we had selected, and we should have 4.5 hours and 4 created. So there you can see it, and I've actually marked it as complete for that routing step. So that was the item we, or sorry, that was the entry we just made, and here I can process that. Let's process all of them here. And that's it. So now these entries will be reflected against your released production order in Business Central. And that's it. That's the whole module. So what you saw was we had released production orders in Business Central against which we could book both time as well as record any items that we manufactured. We can flag various routing steps as complete or not, and those that will close or what's called finish those routing steps in the system. And all that flows directly from Moniroo to Business Central. So that was pretty much the entire module. We've also got a clock in, clock out feature as well that I'll take you through in one of our future videos. If you enjoyed this video, please like the video on YouTube, and also you should subscribe to our channel. We have plenty of additional content coming your way. As always, if you have any questions or want to inquire about adding this functionality to your system, you can always email info@websand.com. Thank you. Have a great day.